Savannah's fight was cancelled recently, and it's been rescheduled. Obviously, I mean, there must have been so much thought and to gone into that about what he was going to do with it, but in the end, they decided to pull the show. And there's a lot of collateral damage there with, you know, stuff that comes off it, but he felt it was the right thing to do, and it's back on again for a new date.
Well, you know, we all had a chat, the team, and, you know, spoke to Sky, you know, Adam Smith, Ben Shalom, you know, John Lushuza, we all spoke about it, and, you know, they said, you know, it does need to go off. It wasn't my decision, you know, but they conferred with us with it. And look, we've only got one queen, and she's passed away. Life to me is worth more than any event anyway. So to show the respect for the Queen is a massive thing. So I got no problem at all. So basically, it is what it is. But let's look, it's happened. It's beyond anybody's control. It wasn't ideal. But the Queen's passed away, so I understand it. Yeah. And let's give maximum respect what is due. And she was a great woman for the country, a great person, and a believer in the blessed Lord. So, you know, she was a faultless woman, so she needs all the respect. As far as the fight goes, 15th of October. So I said to Savannah, you know, you've got to class this like you've had the fight. Because you've got a hard camp, there's a lot of emotions running and everything else. So she's had the week off. I've not seen her since that day, since it was called off. And she's back in the gym on Tuesday. But obviously it's a funeral tomorrow. And we're back in the gym on Tuesday and back to work.
How did Savannah take the whole sort of, you know, knowing that he was going to get called off? How did she get her head round? Not obviously the circumstances, but knowing where she was fitness wise, her head was all prepared for that night. And how do you bring her back down and get her back up again, if you like?
Well, the good thing with Savannah, it's happened to her before. She's not new to this, you know. I got COVID and the last one was off. That got put back 2 weeks. This has been put back 4 weeks or whatever. So she's used to it, and in boxing, she knows now, you know, you can expect the unexpected. So it's not really, obviously, the work that goes in and everything else, it's on another level, especially that level. You know, it's happened, so she's a realist. She didn't say a lot, she just said, okay, let me know when I'm back in the gym, and we'll get to work. So she's a professional, and she knows it's just a blip. No problem.
And as a trainer, you know, like you're getting to peak for that night, how do you sort the training out now and knowing that she's ready again and hitting that same peak in another 4 weeks, you know?
Because, you know, you've got to know what you're doing, you know, so that's why she's had 8 or 9 days off, yeah. Probably 10 days before she's back in the gym, and she'll start having an easy week back in, and it'll start building up, and then she'll come down again, and she's ready. But I won't be killing Savannah in the gym because she's already there. All I need to do is pick her up at a certain level, keep her there, drop her back down, away we go again. All the hard work's done. It's still in her tank. You know, what do I need to kill it for? She ain't going to lose all that fitness in 10 days. So basically, leads back into it. Because, you know, we've got our own methods, and my methods have worked up to now, so I'm happy with it.
They're both in the same boat as well, aren't they? Both girls are in the same boat.
They're in the same boat, yeah, and, you know, massive respect to all of them. Yeah. You know, so both of them, so I'm looking forward to a good fight.
Yeah, looking forward to that, definitely.